As we move to the lambing season, we shear the sheep, they're ready to go, but things are a little different than they have been the last few years. If we look at our feed resources, quality of ingredients, and maybe quantity, recognize that once those ewes are shorn, we're looking at about a 25 to 35% increase in the energy needs of those ewes. They certainly need to be fed differently, more feedstuffs, perhaps better nutrient quality, to support her mission to deliver healthy lambs in January, February, and March. In the upper Midwest, as we move into December, lambing time is right around the corner. And one of the first first signals that the lambing time is moving along is that the ewes are shorn. And generally late gestation, the last 2 to 4 weeks of gestation. And as we have as part of our program here at SDSU, our sheep are shorn, and then the next step comes along. We need to have those animals well protected and well fed. And as we turn our attention to that, we look at the nutritional needs of those animals. This year, following a drought, the feedstuffs are not near as ample, and nutrient quality is a bit of a question. We have lots of producers, including here at our sheep unit, offering corn silage. There's a few things that need to be recognized, that corn silage is a great source of energy, but devoid in most other nutrients, including protein, minerals, and vitamins, and it has some concern over a disease called listeriosis or circling disease. So top quality management is certainly important if we're including corn silage in the diet and unfamiliar with that practice. But as we look at this ewe flock, once they're shorn, we can get an idea their body condition. We expect those ewes to be gaining body weight through the latter part of their gestation, and more importantly, putting on some reserves for those ewes to turn to during lactation to help feed those baby lambs that are at side. So the production cycle is beginning, and really on often. As we look at shearing those ewes just ahead of the lambing season, I think it kicks a lot of thoughts into mind. Are the vaccines up to speed? Our nutritional regimen in place? Do we have our lambing supplies ordered and ready to go? Because as we turn the corner into January, often we start in earnest in the lambing season here in the upper Midwest. If you have questions about using corn silage in sheep diets, turn to SDSU iGrow, as information would be available on recommendations in using that feedstuff in a sheep feeding program.